good and you cut me down. So I string you up to keep you hanging around. You dish the hot stuff up, but you keep me waiting. So I'll play it dirty till your body is breaking. We've got to make love, the time is right. We've got to make love tonight. Cause we're burning up. You make me greedy, you won't feed me my food. But I'll make out easy cause I see straight through you. You cool me off and hot me up, and that's not right. Cause you'll get hungry in the shade of the night. And then we'll make love just when it's right. And when we make love tonight, you out in the cold sweat. And as you lose control of your very soul, your desire takes over. You'll feel a heat sway, your arms are miles away, and suddenly you'll know that you're burning up.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to episode 5 of the Alex Kendrick Show. For those of you that are tuning in at the very beginning of this lovely broadcast, we have Rae Lil Black on the show today. She is in the adult film industry, thus meaning, you know, she has some really cool videos on the internet. But there's way more to her than just that. She is a wrestling fan, which we'll talk about a lot of. She's a metal fan, which we'll talk a lot of, or talk about a lot of. Nice botch. From there, there's kind of a lot in the middle. So I'm just going to chat here for a minute and see what's up. This is episode 5. If anyone's been watching since the beginning, we've had a pretty diverse lineup. The first episode, I was with all of the guys I was on the last tour I was on with overseas in Europe. We talked about coming back last minute, having to cancel shows, et cetera, kind of what that was like. Second episode, we had members from Lorna Shore, Origin, Thyroid is Murder, Rings of Saturn on as well, just talking about how COVID-19 has been impacting them as well.
pretty much every tour that was going on, if not every tour that was going on, has been canceled as of now and indefinitely. So, you know, we talked about a lot of that. Episode 3 was Necrogoblicon Takeover, who actually had no shows booked during this time, fortunately for them, which was very interesting, if you want to go back and look at that. This past episode, we actually had a former WWE superstar, Eric Rowan, on the show, along with John Goblicon. And that was something huge. I never thought we would have kind of escalated that quickly with the podcast, stream, show, whatever have you. And here we are in episode 5, and we have the awesome Rae Lil Black with us, who I've been following on the internet for quite some time, and it is cool. I noticed that she is a metal fan, so the second I kind of was thinking who to get for the next episode, my good friend Mike Caputo gave me this idea, and here we are now. She was very nice about wanting to come on the show, very responsive, and seems like she's pretty excited for it. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and have her on. Hey, Rae, can you hear me? Oh, it looks like you're muted. Let's
okay,
see.
I think.
There we go.
I'm here right now.
Yeah, hey, how are you?
Hi, I'm good. I'm a little bit sleepy, but I'm good.
Yeah, it's early, huh?
Yeah, it's 9 o'clock. It's not too early. It's okay.
Yeah, it's kind of like a late night show for us, kind of vibe. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you. I'm so excited to talk a lot of things about. Yeah, no, not you, but like a metal or wrestling or my career. Oh, you.
Yeah. I mean, you know, we'll keep the focus on you, you know.
Okay.
No one's here to talk about me. No one wants to hear about
me.
I mean, maybe they do. You know, maybe. Where are you right now? You're in Japan now.
Yes, I am in Japan. I live in Japan, unfortunately.
Unfortunately? Why do you say that? You don't like it?
I mean, like, there's nothing to do right now. I mean, nothing to do in Japan. It's too peaceful.
Too peaceful. I don't think there's anything to do anywhere right now, though. Just with How has COVID-19 affected you? And I noticed that you're not working right now.
No.
So is that just... Tell us what that's like. How is...
In Japan, there's actually no quarantine in Japan. Like, the government is saying, like, oh, if it's okay, could you please stay at home? But, like, it's not, like, necessary.
Right. So it's not enforced.
It's not forced. Yeah.
Okay. But that did stop you from working. Is there any reason in particular? Or are you just worried about the... The disease?
Yeah. No, I mean, like, actually, I'm not working since October.
Oh, okay. I was thinking it was just COVID. So, okay.
No, my main, like, field is Europe.
Okay.
And I'm not working in Japan, actually.
Right. So you travel?
Yeah, I travel. Like, I just finished my university this March. So
I'm a student. Awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you. So I was kind of busy.
Yeah. Well, what were you studying, if you don't mind my asking?
I was studying law and politics.
Oh, very cool.
Now I have a law degree. I don't look like, but...
Yeah, no, I mean, you don't have to suit one certain look, you know? What do you plan on going into the law field?
I don't think so. I didn't do job hunting, and now I'm here sitting on the in front of the computer every day.
Yeah.
And talking to people.
Right. Well, at least there's that. Do you have any plan on going back into doing more films?
I had a plan. Of going to moving to Spain actually in March last month.
Okay.
But they traveled, like a travel ban happened, and then now I'm here, stuck in Japan. My apartment is there. Yeah. Paying the $2,000 rent for every month.
Oh no, that's horrible.
For nothing.
Yeah, so you're paying for this apartment in Spain while you're all the way in Japan.
Yeah.
Oh no. So, how soon realistically do you think you can get out there?
I don't know. It really depends on the COVID-19 situation.
Right. Yeah, I know most of my tours for the year are canceled, so we're already looking for next year at this point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some of my friends told me, the festival is not going to happen. Like, festivals are all canceled, and then, like, oh.
Oh, yeah, festival season's pretty much, unfortunately, not going to happen this year.
You think so?
I think maybe a couple, you know, but I think that it'll be, the attendance will be hard to get that many people because people will be kind of scared to go back into public with that many people. And just getting a country to allow that many people at once, I think, is a little hard.
Mm-hmm.
Just right now. But what is it?
It's such a shame. Like, I have nothing to look for now.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I've been noticing that a lot, actually. Like, everyone's looking, you know, I mean, the same, because I was supposed to go and do, you know, the festivals and, you know, do some stuff overseas. And, you know, I love the festival season. It's great for the audience. It's great for the bands, the crew, and everyone. But
and then it's your job.
Yeah, exactly. And then that's why I'm doing this now.
It's fun.
I have so much free time. It's fun.
Well, same. Like, I'm doing this every day. Like, 2 days ago, I did like 9-hour, 10-hour stream.
Oh my goodness. That is a very long one. I couldn't imagine. I think our longest one was a bit over 2 hours last week with Eric Rowan on it.
Eric, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I want to say that was the longest one.
I have nothing to do, so I'm just sitting here talking to people and killing some time.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's a good way to do it. It's productive, nonetheless.
Kind of.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Now I'm addicted to, like, gaming and, yeah.
Yeah, totally. Well, I'm going to keep it on just a bit of a topic for a second and just kind of go back into some of the film questions and stuff for set, if you don't mind.
I don't mind at all. Ask me anything.
Yeah. How did you get started in the in that industry?
It was really... I wasn't thinking of doing this. Like, I was in girls' junior high school. I was in girls' high school, and then I haven't talked to boys for, like, 6 years.
Yeah.
And then I was, like, I was so horny.
Really? Yeah?
I mean, you're a teenager. What do you do? You just bang, or you just do stuff. You just, like, go hang out, party, and... like, smashing around.
Yeah.
But, like, I was always at the library studying, reading books, and listening to music. And then I was a big fan of music already at that time. And then I was watching, like, a YouTube video of, like, Tommy Lee banging Pamela Anderson. And, like, I was my God, this is the world I want to go. And I was like, oh, God, I cannot wait to, like, graduate and then do party. And then I explored, kind of.
Yeah. Then what point did you start, doing it full time?
This month. It was supposed to be this month.
Yeah.
It was a part-time job for me because, like, I was only working, like, 2 months a year.
Okay.
Because of the school. Like, I was shooting only when I have a vacation, like a summer holiday or winter holiday.
Mm-hmm.
Like a spring holiday. So I wasn't, like, a full-time the actress.
Right.
But now okay. I graduated and then I was ready to be a full time.
Yeah, totally. It seems like you kind of got a lot of success pretty quick with everything. You know?
Probably. I don't know, like, I'm actually not sure how big I am or like how popular I am. Like, I feel like I'm still an amateur, and then I don't feel like I am like a popular.
Yeah. So. Out of curiosity, earlier I searched on Pornhub. You're the 26th highest rank on there, which is pretty good, I would say. That's a lot.
Today it was 24.
24 today? Oh, okay. You checked even more recently. Yeah. You went
up. I'm checking like almost every day, and like my fans are checking it, and then they tell me, so.
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty big, though. I mean, and the grand scheme of things. I would think.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I'm going to try my best to be more bigger.
Right. Yeah. Well, I mean, I guess that's always the goal, is to try and master your craft, you know?
It's been so hard, though. Like, I couldn't work for, like, half a year, so.
Yeah. Let's see. What was your favorite scene that you've shot so far?
I actually enjoy most of the scenes. So, like, most of them are my favorite.
Right, so it's kind of hard just to pick one.
I can enjoy, really, like, I can enjoy, like, anything.
Mm-hmm.
Usually, so, yeah. Yeah,
that's fair.
Most of your favorite.
It's hard to pick a favorite.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Has there been any like awful experiences on set, or like something went bad?
Let me think. Maybe like. Usually, like, I don't really care about a look, or I don't really care about the size or anything. I don't really care about anything. But once the guy was super turned off.
Yeah.
I think that's it, really.
Just couldn't really perform.
God, I don't know why, but this guy is super turned. Like, I know why, but, like, this guy's so turned off, and then I just gotta take it, like, oh, can I just, like, finish this scene, like, right now? And I was like, oh, God. But the funny thing is, that scene is actually one of my, like, a popular scene.
Really?
Yeah. I'm not gonna tell you which one, but... I can tell you which one, but that is one of the the top selling. Like, I think that it video itself, I think I made like 20,000 or so.
Oh wow!
So I'm like, gracious. Okay.
Yeah.
So I was like, mean, okay.
Sometimes it's worth the bit of oddness.
So.
Let's see, we've tried to do best and worst. What's, like, a dream shoot? What's something you, like, what's a scene you have to do?
I would love to do the scene with Asa Akira, if you know her.
Yeah, yeah. I saw you just did a podcast with her the other day, yeah?
Yeah. Yes, I did the live stream with her on Instagram.
How was that?
It was great. Like, first time I met her, I cried.
Really?
I cried. But at that time, like, it was more comfortable, like, a relaxing mood, and, yeah.
So is she, like, one of your role models, or so to say, or, like, industry superheroes?
Yeah,
or?
Yeah, I mean, like, she is, like, she's not the only one, but, like, she is the biggest Asian the star in my industry.
Yeah.
So I just want to be like her.
Totally. That makes sense. Well, yeah. I think that you're doing your doing a great job, and you're definitely on the way to
Hopefully, yeah. Let's see what's waiting in my future.
Totally. So, say aside from Asa, anyone else you're just dying to shoot with?
Rocco C. Freddy.
Yeah. Rocco.
Yeah, I mean, like, he's one of the legends in Europe. Yeah. I mean, not only in Europe, like, he's one of the legends.
Totally.
So, yeah, I mean, I already shoot it with, like, Emmanuel Ferreira.
Yeah.
And Karen Lee. So, yeah, I guess, like, I have, like, some people to do, like a Johnny Sins. I'm dying to shoot with Johnny. Got this such a high quality meme.
Yeah.
He got a lot of cool memes, so I love him so much. It's not the only reason, but
you're just in it for the memes, huh?
I'm just trying to get a meme.
Yeah.
With him.
One day. Yeah. I'm sure you have a meme somewhere.
Yes, I have. I have some, like, 3 or 4 or 5.
I'm sure that they'll pop up soon. Mm-hmm. Let's see. I'm trying to think. I'm gonna keep drilling you with questions, and then we'll get to the fun stuff. have you ever had, like, an embarrassing moment on set?
Embarrassing moment. Not really. Like, I don't get embarrassed that much, but, like, I wanted to go pee so bad at some shoot, and then I was like, oh, I cannot really hold, and it was outdoor, and so I was like, oh, what should I do? And then I was like, okay, can I do this in the car? And then they were like, oh, okay, yeah, let's do that scene. And then it happened. So I wasn't embarrassed that much, but, like, I was like, yeah,
right,
okay, if you're fine with that.
Yeah. Sometimes it's nature, you know?
Yeah, I mean, there's no toilet, so I was like, okay, let's do this scene.
Have you ever had any, like, really weird requests or anything during a shoot that you didn't want to do?
Not really. But, like, I get a lot of, like, I accept any fetishes, but, like, one of the fetish I'm curious, or, like, I don't really get it, is, like, mm-hmm. hair fetish, or, like, hair fetish,
mm-hmm.
or ear hole fetish, or... I was like, oh, why ear hole? But I was like, yeah, okay.
Yeah. What do you think is worse, like an ear hole or a belly button?
I don't know. Ear, maybe? Because, like, if you finish there, like, it's going to be a trouble. You can clean...
Yeah, that's...
You can clean your belly, but you cannot clean side of the ear hole.
You bring up a really good point. Yeah. I guess
you don't want to have your kids in there, you know?
Right, right. So, now that we know that ears aren't really, like, your fetishes, what are some of your, like, personal fetishes? Like, if you could do, you're, like, directing your own scenes all the time and stuff like that.
My fetish is smell or sweat.
Okay.
So, it's not really a big fetish, but it's not that you can show a lot, but, like, I like... not drinking, but, like, not eating, but, like, licking off the sweat.
Yeah, I understand.
And, and smell.
Yeah. So sweaty. You're into, like, the sweaty smell, like the must kind of everything.
It's so good.
Yeah, it's like a nature-y primal kind of thing in your brain, I think.
Yeah, you can tell. I mean, you can, like... instantly tell that, oh, we're gonna have a great time, or oh, right. No, this, yeah. I don't think so.
Yeah. It's like, do I have to?
Yeah, I can tell. Like, oh, it's going to be a good time.
Yeah. You walk in and you were kind of tired before and then you're really excited.
Yeah.
Have you ever had any like crazy fan experiences for anyone recognizing you in public or stuff like that?
Most of the time they recognize me. Every time they recognize me, they are super nice. Like they're like super politely asking me to like to take a picture with them or like get some autograph or whatever or shake hands.
Yeah,
but on the internet there are so many creeps. Yeah.
Yeah, I can imagine it's kind of a cesspool of kind of disgusting stuff on the internet. But
yeah, I mean, like there are so many like stalkers and like the people who is obsessed with me. Like I don't mind, but like I was like, oh, this is the internet world.
Yeah, how do you deal with that? Did you just kind of like block it out? Like just right from the beginning, or do you like go through and read some of it, or?
And I'm just gonna ignore.
Yeah, just right off the bat. That's probably the easiest thing to do.
But like, I am so I have some respect for them. I'm like, I'm ignoring everything, and they keep like messaging me, and they're like, oh, they have like steel heart, like I don't have. So I'm right. Like, oh.
It's persistency,
respect,
you know.
Respect, dude.
So no like crazy weird ones in person though, yeah. Just pretty nice people then.
Yeah, usually.
That's good. Sometimes at metal shows we'll have what's called punishers. Which is people it's like a fan, but like a fan that's overboard but in a bad way.
Oh.
Because Like, they'll follow you everywhere, which for me, I don't have to worry about because I'm just a sound guy. But the other guys, they have to deal with that. And it's like people that'll follow you everywhere. Once they're done with a picture, they'll just kind of follow you still everywhere. And
is it like so like super fan?
Yeah, but like in an uncomfortable way, you know?
Oh.
Not like in a nice, polite way, but just in a weird, creepy, just their way, you know?
Oh. Maybe. Yeah, I haven't thought of that, like...
Yeah, it would be, I imagine, like, the, for example, for you, it would be if someone, after, like, they got an autograph or picture, just, like, maybe kept following you, or... Yeah, and then just, like, kept asking you questions over, like, after the experience was already done, you know? Like, just keeps asking and asking.
Is that a common thing for, like, the guy from the band, or...
I would say so. Yeah, it's pretty common, but again, like not all, like I use the term punishers, but not all of it's bad. Like, you know, usually they're nice people, you know, mm-hmm. Totally. But,
are some people,
it could be either gender. Oh. A punisher is gender neutral.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just overwhelming. And I mean, you don't even really have to be a musician. I guess anyone could have a punisher, but someone that just like, you know, it's overwhelming and maybe a bit annoying, sort of harassing in a way.
I mean, I think that they want to talk and then get closer. This kind of thing, right?
Yeah, totally. But like pushes too hard.
Oh.
You know, and like in an uncomfortable way.
I kind of get it.
Yeah. I totally get it. Cause, like,
I'm usually awkward.
Yeah, me too.
So I'm like, oh, I want to talk, but what should I do? Maybe deal like this. I don't know.
Yeah. I'm sure, like, I've totally been a punisher before. Maybe. Who knows? Maybe. Back to you, though. I'll ask, do you have a favorite director you've worked with yet?
Me? Myself.
Yeah. Like self-directing,
I mean,
like, the most?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't worked a lot of production. I haven't worked with a lot of production. And then it was a super casual, like, not directing, kind of. Like, it was super, how do I say? Like, it's straight going to the physical connection, like physical.
Yeah, yeah.
So like it wasn't a much. It wasn't. There wasn't a lot of dilution. So I actually don't know like the real director. Like I have worked with Kaiden Cross. Mm-hmm. I think she is the only one who is like super directing everything, and then you did this, you did that, and
yeah. So aside from that, it's been just kind of a lot of you kind of doing your own thing.
Yeah, I mean, I was like, yeah, I want to do this, I want to do that, and they're like, okay, and then I just.
Well, that's gotta be pretty nice though, because then you know you're kind of in control of your scene, kind of, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because like I always tell the production that I'm super awful. With acting, I'm not good at acting, so I just tell them like, oh please, I don't want to do this, I want to do Gonzo, like I want to do Gonzo scene, so please don't do it, and then they're like okay, so it's some small interaction, and then
then just, you know, the action happens.
Mm-hmm. The action happens.
Yeah.
Some wrestling.
Yeah, the heavyweight champion is, you know, winning that one. Let's go wrestling for a minute. How long have you been following wrestling?
It was like on and off. It's been ages to come back to like come back to watch wrestling actually. I started watch wrestling when I was in like high school.
Okay.
I was like, I was watching like a WWE or some Japanese promotions. And then like I graduated high school, and then I went to university, and I got super, busy.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, I left the wrestling because I didn't have time, and then I'm back because now I have time. And then my favorite promotion is in my hometown, so yeah, I was like, yeah, why not?
What promotion is that?
It's called Dragon Gate, if you know.
Oh, okay, I've actually heard of Dragon Gate, but I'm not that familiar.
Oh, it's really good. They're super fast. The matches are super fast. It's more like a lucha style.
Okay. I'll have to look into that.
It's really nice. Like I sometimes like I have a my Friday is the wrestling Friday in my stream. So we watch wrestling on Friday for like some hours.
Yeah, I think I saw that the other day. I love the wrestling stream idea. It's actually a great idea. I feel like I could sit around and talk about wrestling forever. Go ahead. No, you got it.
No, I mean like I'm saying like there's a wrestling Friday, but like I'm watching wrestling stuff every day with everybody. Anyway.
Oh, yeah. Do you have the WWE network?
No, actually, like, but I'm thinking of getting it because like this is getting too bored.
Yeah. I actually have it, and I spend too much time. I spend way too much time watching it. Nice.
Yeah, like you can find some shows on YouTube, but like you cannot have like full matches. So, yeah, right. I have a Dragon Gate like network, then I'm watching it, but like there's a limit. I mean, I have a lot of time and watching a lot, so now I'm like,
it can definitely get overwhelming. Have you been watching the most recent Raw and SmackDowns ever since they've been doing the empty arenas?
Mm-hmm. But I have to check. Like, people in my, like, Discord. Do you know Discord?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a Discord. I have a Discord, and then I have a wrestling channel. And then they're like, how was today's something, Raw or, like, SmackDown, whatsoever. And I was like, oh, I think I have to, I have to follow the story or stuff again
I haven't really been watching much at all. I've just because the lack of the audience there, and I like that they're still doing it, but it kind of takes away to me.
Oh, really? Like the Dragon Gate was doing the Don't Know audience show, and then I actually really loved it.
Yeah,
yeah. I mean, they're an entertainer, so I actually liked it.
It could be the difference, though, in my opinion, because WWE is so much more dramatic and, like, more storyline and less wrestling, even. Like, AEW even has more wrestling matches, you know? So maybe it's just WWE is doing it kind of dumb to me.
Yeah, I mean, like, WWE is, like, the crowds make the matches, too. The crowd's reaction and crowd's, like, the voice of the crowd. That makes it, like, everything, the atmosphere and stuff. So maybe that's why.
Okay, have you seen any AEW? Have you been watching any of that?
I was just the other day, like, 2 days ago or something, I was watching, like, the... Who was that? Like, he changed the name to the... Moxley? Moxley?
Oh, yeah.
John Moxley?
Dean Ambrose, now John
Moxley. Yeah, Dean Ambrose. And then I was like, oh, okay, he now back to the Moxley. So I'm like, oh.
Yeah, I actually really like it. I feel like they're giving him way more freedom, you know, into his character.
Yeah, and then, I mean, Jericho is there. Like, Jericho is now in AEW, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And then, like, my people, like, my fans are saying, like, hey, now it's AEW is so good. And then people are like, pre-check AEW and let's watch it.
Yeah. I haven't been watching as much as I'd like, I'll probably end up doing that right after this is done, actually. Now I know what I'm going to do. But did you watch WrestleMania at all this year?
No.
Nope, not at all.
I'm not, like, it's so exhausting to follow a lot of promotions.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I was like, okay, this year I'm going for Dragon Gate. But I am happy to, like, check out, because since I started, like, streaming, and then people talk a lot about streaming, like, a lot of promotions. So, I want to check.
Yeah, totally. I'll have to check out Dragon Gate, too.
It's so good. But, like, it's so different. It's so different to the American wrestling.
Yeah, I mean, who knows? Maybe I'll love it.
it's good, but it's more like a wrestling.
Yeah, totally, which I personally like. I don't like that there's as much talking and, like, so many scenes. Yeah, there's too much talking in WWE to me.
Yeah, but, like, it's usually they're good at, like, mic performance.
Yeah, doing, like, a mic spot or something.
Yeah, and then I don't get 100%, but, like, I still enjoy it.
yeah. I just think that they do it, just in my opinion, more than they should. Like, I was watching, I think, Raw maybe a week or two ago, but I noticed it was, like, 40 minutes into the episode and no matches.
Yeah. 40 minutes is kind of long. It's like...
Yeah, it was just a promo and then something and then another promo, and next thing you know, it's 40 minutes, no match. It's like I want to watch wrestling, not just sitcom.
Yeah, I mean, you want to watch naked guy hanging around and smashing their bodies. Yeah,
that's what I want to do, you know.
that's what we people want to watch.
Yeah, there's a reason it sells out arenas, you know. have you let's see, you said it's not really on quarantine, so that kind of bunks one of my other questions, but, like, have you gathered any new hobbies or anything on your downtime? I guess you started streaming, so that's kind of new.
Yeah, I mean, like, I'm streaming, like 7-8 hours a day, usually.
Are you doing all 7 days a week?
Yeah. Usually. Wow. So, this is my everything.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, but, like, I'm back to wrestling. Like, I am now start watching wrestling again, and, like, not only Dragon Gate, and now I have some time to, like, listen to some music on stream also.
Yeah, what kind of music have you been listening to? I know you're a big metal fan.
Yes, I am a big metal fan. Like, I actually listen to anything, like, from hard rock to, like, heavy metal to black metal, death metal.
Yeah, yeah. What are some albums or bands you've been listening to lately?
Lately? And the Spot Crown, I got the CD from Spot Crown, like, a few weeks ago, so I've been listening to that.
Those guys are cool. They're from France, yeah?
Yeah, they are, like, they're one of my favorite guys.
I did a tour with, they were on in 2015, actually, in the United States.
Oh, nice. I've seen them twice, actually, in Europe.
Yeah, they're a crazy good band. Mm-hmm. Super heavy stuff.
Yeah, they're underrated, to be honest with you.
I think most heavy metal or death metal is, but yeah.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, but, like, not many people listening to it. Like, they're like, oh, the young people are like, oh, that is the music for lame people, like the nerds. What's that? I'm like, oh, you guys don't have a taste in music.
Yeah, yeah, kind of. You see a lot of, like, the newer generation, if you will, just kind of liking the, for lack of better words, more hardcore core breakdowns and stuff as opposed to the...
Yeah, I mean, they just like to, like, they just like to, like, smash people in the mosh pit, probably.
Yeah, yeah. Which, I mean, you know, to each his own. Fun, everyone has their, you know, fun. Do you see yourself in a mosh pits very frequently?
not really. Sometimes, yeah. But, like, yeah, like, every time I go, like, mosh pit or surf, I get a lot of bruise.
Yeah,
bruise, and then I sometimes have a shooting, so I'm like, oh.
Then you show up with bruises. Yeah,
and then I think I shouldn't do it too often if I have a shooting. But if I don't have a shooting, I sometimes do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, like, I'm super tiny, so.
Yeah, I imagine it could be pretty easy to get lost in the ruckus of whatever's going on. Circle pit, mosh, whatever.
Mm-hmm. I try not to do that in Europe. I sometimes do it in Japan, but I don't do it in America or Europe.
Yeah.
Too big.
Yeah, sometimes the mosh pits get pretty big, especially at some of those European festivals.
Yeah, I've never been to outdoor festival.
Oh, wow.
I've never been to outdoor festival, but, like, I've seen a lot of YouTube video on, like, super huge, like, hurricane happening. And...
Right, yeah, that would be pretty scary to get lost in the middle of.
Yeah.
Even for myself, I'm 6'2", and I would not go anywhere near that.
Yeah, but I wanted to go to the outdoor festival this year, but, yeah, it's not going to happen, unfortunately.
Well, fingers crossed, there's always hope for next year, and maybe we can make them earlier in the near next year. Maybe it won't be so late. I don't know. I don't get to make that decision, but it would be a cool idea. Maybe have earlier festivals, and then everything is open, make sure everyone's safe, and then safely start having concerts again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's see what we're going to have.
Yeah, what was one of the last metal concerts you went to?
Let's see, I don't actually remember. It was like a month ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, let's check. I think it's obituary.
Oh, it's totally fine. Yeah, you got it. Obituary.
Obituary.
Yeah, you got it.
I think it's Obituary or Kiss.
Mm. Hmm. Pretty big gap. It could be one of those two.
Yeah. Like, I listen to anything, so...
Yeah, yeah. I kind of find myself listening to less metal as of, like, the last 5-6 years just because I'm surrounded by it so much on tour.
Yeah, I get it, really. I get it.
Yeah. I also noticed.
You get tired of it.
Oh, yeah. You get pretty. There's only so much that you can hear before it's a little overwhelming on the ears. But it's extremely crazy, though, when you do enjoy it, you know?
Yeah.
Some of those drummers are insane.
Yeah.
I noticed you were also playing some games on your stream. Are you big into games?
No, like, I just started like 3 weeks ago.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not a gamer. I just started.
How's that going? Do you like it or?
Yeah. So far, I am loving it.
I recently just started playing video games again myself. I bought a PlayStation 4 after this last tour. We had to leave Europe early to come back, blah, 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 and we had all this downtime, so I started playing that, and I've only been playing for a month or so, but I've only been playing Call of Duty.
Oh, nothing else. Is that good? Like, so many people, like, are like, oh, please play Call of Duty.
Yeah, I've been playing Warzone. It's a Call of Duty game, but it's free to play, and it's free to download. I recommend it. We can give it a try later. Worst case.
You're liking it?
Yeah, I've been playing it. I've probably already logged 50 to 60 hours on it in the last few weeks to a month, so a fair bit.
Alex is a terrible driver named Warzone.
Shout out Mike Caputo. That is the drummer for Rings of Saturn. I don't think I'm that terrible of a driver at Warzone.
Oh. There's a big capital, like a terrible there.
Yeah, no, I see it. I see it. He says, "You're such a bad driver."
Oh.
So obviously you should get Warzone and see how bad my driving is.
Okay. I would definitely love to find out how bad you are.
I really don't think it's as bad as he's saying it is. But, you know, maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, let's see. I'm bad at driving, too, so. In the real life.
Yeah, I try and avoid it as much as possible.
So, yeah.
What's one of your favorite games that you've been playing? I know you said you're new at it, but...
Yes, I started playing Dead by Daylight 3 days ago.
How's that been going?
So good. I totally recommend it. Like, so good.
What is the game about? Is it?
It's like one killer and four survivor, and then the killer is gonna hunt these people, and then we have to survive. We have to fix the generator, like five generator out of six or seven, and then we have to fix five, and then the killer is like. They're trying to hunt us, and then it's like that.
Yeah.
So good. Like, I don't like to play a killer, but they have a lot of selection of the killer. Like, you can select some movie the killers from the movies, like how it's called, like Texas Chainsaw or.
Oh, Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Yeah, like there are a lot of. Yeah, monsters.
What was the name of it again? The game?
Dead by Daylight.
Okay, I'll have to check it out. I certainly have plenty of free time right now.
So. It's so good, really. Please get it. Let's squad up and then play.
Yeah, we should.
It's so good.
Is it an online multiplayer?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll do it.
Like, I was streaming 9 hours, like, the 2 days ago. It was all this.
Really?
Yeah.
How was that? Like, do people, stay involved for you during the whole chat or the whole stream?
They're nice. They're just watching me screaming and, slapping the table and, hitting stuff. Because it's so stressful. Seriously, it's super stressful.
I'll have to give it a try then. I don't know if I want to go breaking stuff, but we'll see.
I mean, seriously, it's so good.
Yeah, I haven't played video games in so long until this. I would say before I only had the original Xbox, and then I quit playing video games up until probably a month ago. So I've just been playing this one game, but I'll have to get that one and see. do you ever find yourself checking out bands around where you live, like underground metal bands or anything like that?
You mean in Japan?
Yeah.
I have a friend, like I have friends who's doing the bands, and I check them out sometimes, but I'm not like I'm a big fan or so. Like they just invite me, so I just okay, I'm going just to like hang to drink and then listen to them, of course. But it's not like
you're going out of your way just to find a random concert.
No.
Yeah.
Like in Japan, the community is super close. So if I go there, there's a family. I feel like there's a family there, and then I kind of don't. It's impossible to get inside of the family.
Yeah.
Kind of.
I know what you mean. Like it's a small circle kind of.
Yeah, it's a small circle, and then the people who is there is always there, and then I cannot really like get
can't really get in.
Yeah.
I know what you mean.
So I like when I'm not invited or when somebody wants me to check out, I don't really go.
Yeah.
Anymore.
Have you ever been to, and feel free not to say any names at all, have you ever been to a show that was just really, really horrible? It was just absolutely trash and you had to leave? Because I have. I definitely won't say who. I definitely have. Yeah.
Oh, I am so curious. But you're not going to tell me.
No, I can't say who. That's a okay, conflict of interest.
You can text me later.
Yeah. How about for you, though?
I have seen some, but performance, yes. And they are a super big band.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it was in Norway.
Isn't that always really discouraging when it's like a super big band or something and then you see the live show and it's just kind of like a...
Oh, crap. Disappointment. Like, yeah, I mean, like, I love their music in their CDs or vinyl. I like listening to their music in vinyls or CDs, but I don't think I would like the live show.
There's a lot of artists kind of like that. Like most of the stuff I listen to or find myself listening to, I don't think I would ever go to a concert for.
Oh yeah.
Because a lot of it, I mean, like I would. I don't think most of the things I listen to even like tour. Like it's all just kind of like underground weird instrumental stuff, and like it's not even really bands, just random stuff I find on the internet. Let's see. By the way, if you're watching on Twitch, feel free to ask some questions. We will take some questions.
Live show sucks. He said it. I didn't say that. I didn't say that early. I love going to the show. I love going to shows. But I saw some bands who like which is not good at performing. I saw
what
some.
Okay, so this will be a fun one. What's more, or what's less satisfying, a band that can't perform or someone on set that can't perform? Like, if you were filming.
Oh, it's a tough question. But, band maybe, because, like, I travel over the countries to see people. Usually, like, I traveled 35 countries to 36 countries already.
Nice.
And then, I go to, like, I travel to see them sometimes. From Japan to Europe, or Japan to, like, Australia, or Japan to somewhere. And if they suck at playing, I'm paying thousands of money, and then I get nothing. So
yeah, so that's definitely worse.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Have you been, someone in the Twitch stream, Mike Caputo, says you've been learning to play drums. Mm-hmm. Is that true?
Yeah. Yes.
How's that going?
No, good. Because, like, I don't have a drum set at my place because, like, my room is so tiny and my mom hates metal. So there's no way I can get a drum set.
And have you thought about getting an electronic kit?
No, she's gonna destroy that. She's a like she's a death metal. Like it, she her life is death metal or like black metal. She's brutal. So
really,
yeah, I'm not gonna get that. And then yeah. The studio I am using is like 45 minutes away, like a train ride from my house. So I'm like, oh,
that's not too bad, but it's just far enough to be a little bit annoying.
Yeah, so, and then now the COVID is happening, so I haven't touched the stick or drum for like a month or month and a half.
I've learned that that's the best way to learn how to play drums, is you just set the drumsticks down and you never touch them again. that's the best way.
Yeah, I know. I knew it. Yeah. Yeah.
Have you? Is that something you've always wanted to do? Is learn how to play drums? Or?
Yeah, definitely. Like, every time I go to a show, I am so into the drummer because, like, I'm so fascinated by their feet, yeah. Or the how. Like, it's impossible. You using this hand and that hand and this foot and that.
Yeah, and then for so like the metal. With the crazy speeds, it looks literally impossible sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's crazy. And they are sometimes, like, smiling and talking to people. And then sometimes they're singing. And I'm like, oh, this is, like, a whole like, a new level. Like, oh, yeah, another level.
So maybe that'll be you one day behind the drum kit, you know?
Yeah.
Doing yeah, but, the like, crazy I've, stuff.
Yeah, I've been a big fan of Tommy Lee since I was 12.
Oh yeah, is that like one of your celebrity crushes?
Yeah, no, definitely. So yeah, that's one of the reason, and yeah, it's so fascinating to see their thing.
Yeah.
Thing.
Okay, so if you say you weren't gonna play drums, is there any other instrument that you want to learn?
No.
It's not at all.
Yeah, because it seems like the guitar seems boring to me.
Uh-oh.
I mean,
uh-oh,
like,
guitar
I love
players.
I love the guitar. Like, I love listening to it, but, like, I cannot really... I don't think that I can concentrate on... I'm not good at fingering, so... I mean, fingering...
Not good at guitar, fingering. You heard it here first.
Fingering guitar. Fingering guitar?
Yeah, or plucking.
Plucking, okay. Strumming. I don't know how to say the word.
Fingering is a separate thing.
Okay, but I don't, like, a drum is, like, more dramatic, dynamic. Like,
yeah.
There's a little move and stuff.
I could see that.
Yeah, and then, like, the sad thing is you cannot, like, the drummer is always, like, so far behind the set, and then I cannot really see. I'm almost like, oh.
That's why a lot of guys, especially, like, headliners, once you get to a certain level, they'll get, like, the risers, you know, so their kit's raised up.
Yeah, but let's do it. It's a bit easier. What's happening here?
Well... You need to find someone and just stand on their shoulders next time.
Maybe, yeah.
Whether they like it or not, just do it, you know? Let's see. So we've covered job stuff, career stuff, wrestling stuff. What's your favorite wrestler? I know I saw you tweet about that. I think you mentioned something about The Rock.
Yeah, I mean, like, he's not my, like, super favorite, but like there's so many people mentioning, like, I post the Instagram post and Twitter asking my fans that who is your favorite wrestler, and then so there's so many people saying The Rock, so I was like, oh, he is the best, like, mic performer. Like, mic performer?
Yeah, yeah. Probably just the best with the mic skills.
Yeah, I think he's the best. He's the best. The guy who can, like, entertain with the mic.
Yeah. Do you like John Cena?
I mean, he seems like a super nice guy.
But I'm waiting for there to be a but maybe there's not a but.
No, I mean, like, he seems like a nice guy, and I mean, like, he is super nice to his fans, it seems. Like, he right. is so super close to his fan, and then I think that he got a really good fan base.
Totally. So, oh no, back to the favorite wrestler thing. Who is your personal favorite wrestler?
My favorite wrestler is, like, he is from Japan, but the guy called Yoshino Masato.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you guys still know him, but he is one of my favorite, and he is such a, like, he got a power, he got a speed, and he is so good at everything.
Is he wrestling with the promotion you mentioned earlier, Dragon Gate?
Or? Dragon Gate. Yeah, well, he's retiring this year, but yeah.
Oh, no.
No. And then COVID is happening, so I'm just like, oh, no.
What a bad year for kind of everything.
Mm-hmm. And then especially what?
Oh, I was just saying, just anything in the entertainment industry, from, you know, wrestling, music, to, you know, or I'm sure even what most adult film stuff is shut down, right? Or no, you know.
Yes, it is shut down.
Yeah, so it's crazy how COVID-19 has already just shut everything down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Dragon Gate. The Crazy Monkey King. The Dragon Gate now has an Ultimo Dragon. Yes. He started this Dragon Gate. It was like a Torimon, but the Ultimo Dragon started this Dragon Gate. So yeah.
Definitely gonna have to look that up after this.
Yeah, and then when I was a teenager, I loved Randy Orton.
Oh yeah, was it the looks? It had to have been the looks.
I mean, he got a good muscle, and he is strong, and then, like, not too strong. Like, he is strong, but, like, not like a super, like,
He's not like Brock Lesnar.
Like, he's not he's not undefeatable.
Right. Right.
Yeah. So I liked him so much when I was in high school. Like, I had a, like, figure, like a super small toys, and yeah.
I think one of my favorites of all time has just been The Undertaker.
Why though? Like, there's so many people love Undertaker. Like, he is so cool. I know he's so cool, but why? What part is the attraction? Like, what attracts you?
I think when I was just, like, when I was first introduced to The Undertaker, I was probably like 6 or 7 years old, so, like, really young watching, and he just, like, looked like that scary, dark guy, you know, and he kind of just made the whole room or crowd, you know, have this ominous feeling. Mm-hmm. And I kind of liked the crowd control and just the weird presence that he brought, and just maybe just the darkness-y, you know, I don't really know what exactly there, but
I mean, his entrance is always amazing.
Yeah, for lack of better words, I love his gimmick. Mm. It's amazing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, I saw so many people mentioning about Undertaker.
Yeah.
Yeah, Undertaker, and who was it? Let's see who is their favorite wrestlers. Edge, Sting.
Oh, yeah, I liked Randy Orton around the same time they were teaming with Edge. That was a good time for him.
Yeah. Shawn Michaels. Kenny Omega. The Kenny Omega is killing.
I love Kenny Omega. Yeah.
Like, he got a lot of fans right now.
Yeah, Kenny Omega's awesome. I've never been able to see him wrestle in person. I want to.
Yeah, but like now he's killing the game. Yeah, and then The Rock, Hulk Hogan, yeah.
The standards, you know, Brock, yeah. Hogan, yeah, standard, Stone yeah. Cold.
The classic.
Maybe yeah. Someone mentions Kane in there somewhere, Mankind.
Yeah, some people, yeah. Some people love Kane and Mankind, yeah. And, yeah, Rey Mysterio, John Cena, Roman Reigns, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Someone said no mention of Ric Flair. Wow.
No. Yeah. There's so many. Yeah, Ric Flair.
Yeah.
He's good. Like, I was talking to my dad. Like, I was talking about wrestling with my dad yesterday, and he was like, "Oh, I love Ric Flair." I mean, he.
I think Ric Flair is hard not to like.
Right. Like, maybe, yeah.
I mean, what is there not to like about Ric Flair? You know.
Mm-hmm. And then CM Punk, Triple H, yeah. I mean, yeah, the classics.
What's, since we're doing favorite and least favorite stuff, let's come back to that. What's your least favorite wrestler?
Oh.
Like, maybe not least favorite, but just like, who's someone who you like to always watch lose?
Oh. I don't know. I like when John Cena lose.
Yeah.
And because, like, he's such a hero type. Like, he's such a, like, the superhero type. Like, the Captain America type. Or...
Yeah.
Yeah, something, like, super classic and not, you know, have a lot of fans. So, sometimes I like, people, like, getting pissed or, you know...
Yeah, totally. Anything that kind of breaks the normal just
mm-hmm.
mold of, like, good yeah. and bad or whatever
yeah.
it is.
Yeah.
Let's see. Any questions? Triple H's Motorhead entrance song is always pumped. Yeah, mm. Triple H's entrance music is actually one of my favorites.
Mm.
Who do you think has the best entrance music?
Oh... This is not WWE, but I guess you guys don't know about it, but the guy from Dragon Gate has, like, one of my favorite wrestlers. He got a really good entrance. A super... Oops. Yeah, John Cena does, yes. Actually, yes, he got a really good entrance song. Like, you can actually remember it, like, once you listen to it, you cannot... forget about his entrance.
Yeah.
So,
It's got the flashy bits mm-hmm. to remember.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, like, that's actually an important thing, though. I mean, they are entertainer, and you have to be remembered.
Yeah, totally, because then, you know, you got to think, at least to one person watching every night, or in theory every night, that's someone's first impression seeing you, mm-hmm. the entrance to the ring, so you really have to, like, make it impressionable or impersonable, whatever have mm-hmm. you.
Yeah. The Rock entrance was pretty bad, and the auto bridge for Edge.
Mm. So, let me ask, what? Where did you come up with the name? Rae Lil Black.
Oh, the Rae is English name, but like if you say Lei is a Japanese name. So, Rae is something like something the name you can say easily, like Raymond or Rachel, like Rae.
Yeah.
And then you can remember. And then little is I'm just so tiny, like I'm short.
Mm-hmm.
And then black is I like black, so
yeah, really, so it just kind of just ties together pretty nice.
Yeah, I mean, like I thought that I can change it later. Mm-hmm. I thought that I can change it later, but obviously I didn't have chance to change it, and then now
I think it's here to stick.
Yeah, I got to stick. I mean, now I cannot change the name now. It's impossible.
If you were going to change it, what would you change it to? Could you even tell us?
Know.
Maybe someone would steal it. Yeah, no.
No, like, I thought that this name is super lame, but now I kind of start liking it, so...
I think it's a good name. It's original, like, it's easy to remember.
It sounds like a rapper.
Yeah. Sometimes you just have to sound like a rapper.
Maybe. Yeah, like, you cannot imagine that I like metal from this name.
Yeah, totally. Nonetheless, like, I wouldn't imagine the full logo with everything, too. That's good. Yeah. What made you go with the metal logo, kind of?
I mean, I love metal. Like, I didn't want to have, like, a cute, like, a Rae Lil Black, cute, oh, I'm a pretty performer, like, a logo. I didn't want that. Like, it's too boring. Hella boring.
Yeah. Hella boring.
Hella boring. So, like, okay, you know what? I'm going to ask this guy. I asked the artist, and then I'm going to order the logo. And then I told him that, like, can you put some influence of, like, the early black metal bands, like, 90s, like, a super early one. And then I think that you can see some influence from, like, Dark Throne and stuff.
Right.
Yeah. And then, this guy, the guy who made my logo, he was doing the merch design for Mayhem. So I was like, oh, can I do that? And then he was like, okay.
Oh, wow. Yeah that's that's cool. What are so are you super into, like, the old school black metal kind of stuff?
Yeah, I am a big collector of Mayhem. I am. I'm a big fan of Mayhem. Like, I'm a collector. I'm a fan, but, like, I'm more like a collector.
That makes sense, yeah. You like the idea of just collecting more and more.
Yeah, and, like, I cannot stop, really. Like, it's impossible.
How much Mayhem memorabilia do you have? How much stuff?
Oh, massive.
Yeah?
Yeah, I have, like, so many. I sometimes show it to people if they're like, oh, you're faking it, or like some guys are like super mean to me and like, oh, you're just saying poser. And then I'm like, oh, really, do you have this?
Oh,
and I'm like, they're like, oh.
Oh,
do you see that?
Yep. Yeah. Oh, I could see it. It's gone now. There it is. Kind of?
Oh.
There it is. Yeah, if you hold it right in front of yourself, you can see it. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mayhem.
Yeah,
so do you have a... Do you collect other vinyl outside of Mayhem?
Yes, a lot. I have a lot. Not a lot, because I started... Like, I was collecting CDs before vinyl, so I started... collecting vinyls, like, 1 year, 2 years ago, 1 year and a half.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't have so many, but, like, 200-300.
Wow, that's certainly more than I have.
Oh, really?
yeah, I'm kind of, like, on the digital side of just streaming the music, and, like, I'll buy an album, you know, if I really like it, or for some friends, you know, to have on iTunes or something, or a physical, but I don't really play much music on a CD player or record player anymore.
I should,
though. It's nice.
I mean, once you start it, it's impossible to stop.
Yeah.
To be honest.
I could see that. It's kind of like an addicting thing. Once you start getting a few... All you want is just to have them everywhere, you know?
Yeah, I mean, like, I have so many stuff from Mayhem. And, like, I have some, like, a rehearsal tape from, like, a version or, stuff.
Someone asked, did you see Mayhem when they came to Japan 2018?
No, really, because I was not in Japan. Japan. But I've seen Mayhem, like, a few times in Europe, yeah. I've seen them, like, last year. In no way.
Oh, very cool.
Mm-hmm. In Belgium. No, not Belgium. Belgen. in Belgium.
What is what's one of your favorite places in Europe? Is it Spain? Like, is that why you're moving over there, or?
Spain is great. Like, I don't like a cold place, and then I like beach. Yeah. I just want to sleep outside, and it should be sunny. Like, I want the sunny weather and sleeping outside and beach. So, I was like, yeah.
I mean, it's beautiful. I recently went from the first time earlier this year.
And no.
I just went to Madrid and Barcelona, but it was beautiful.
It's so beautiful. I love Barcelona.
Yeah.
So much.
I could definitely spend some more time there.
Yeah, Oh, no, COVID-19, why? I'm going to fuck your ass up. Dude, yeah, shit.
Maybe that's your next scene idea. Rae Lil Black fucks COVID-19. But you make it go away. But you make it go away, you know? So it's like a superhero porn.
Yeah. You know? I mean, every girl's like persona. It's honestly annoying. I mean, yeah, you gotta go there. You're gonna like it if you like the sun and outside. I don't like cold place, so.
I really liked Barcelona just due to the beach bits, but I just like the beach in general.
Yeah, me too. That's why.
Yeah, when we went, I loved it. The venue we were playing was maybe a 10-minute walk from the coast, and it was just a beautiful pier with restaurants, stuff like that. We went for some drinks on the beach, and
yeah, I mean, it's cheap.
So, yeah, that's another thing. It's so cheap in there.
Yeah, I've been to, like, a lot of Scandinavian countries, like, a lot of times. Like, Sweden, Norway, Finland, and Denmark. I've been there, like, several times, but, like, I like the countries, but it's too cold for me, and it's too expensive, so.
Yeah. Definitely don't want to pay overpriced for somewhere where you're freezing the entire time.
Yeah, I mean, I went to the small outdoor festival in Sweden in August, and then in the night it was freezing cold in August. So I was like, oh, I'm not gonna live here. Like, I'm not gonna.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I'm not a fan of the cold myself. I'm currently down in Georgia. I was supposed to be moving to Los Angeles right now across the country, but COVID-19. So
yeah, it's fucking you up.
Yeah, it's fucking everything. It is the absolute worst. Mm. Barcelona has some cool record shops and metal merch. When this person. I've never been to any record shops in Barcelona.
Me too. I've been there, actually. But Japan has the greatest record shops. I'm telling you, I've traveled a lot, and then I know that Japan, like a record shop in Japan, is the best.
I think I've only been to maybe 3 or 4 record shops in my entire life.
What?
I don't really go too much.
What?
I've never bought a record. Is that a surprise?
What?
Yeah.
What? Okay, I'm leaving now.
Okay.
What? That's insane.
Yeah, it's crazy. I've bought plenty of CDs and stuff like that, but I've never actually bought a record.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
like, I bought, like, a CD, you know, but I've never bought, like, a vinyl.
I mean, yeah, I think you should stick to like something like CD or vinyl or tapes. Definitely. Like, I have like everything. Like, I have like 500 or 600 of CDs, and now I am like, oh, I have this CD, but I kind of want this in vinyl too. So I'm like, I'm buying double. And then
do you find yourself listening to all those, or do you just really have them sitting around more times than?
I don't listen everything. I'm a collector, but I listen once or twice, and then if it's not good, it's just gonna be my collection.
Right, we'll just leave that there, and it'll just be like another notch in the belt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because like if you're listening to the CD or vinyl, you gotta listen the entire album, and then if the entire album is not good, it's
Someone said, I think a lot of countries' record shops are disappearing because a lot of places are going to digital sales. Do you notice that in Japan?
Japanese people are sticking to the physical.
Yeah, like actually having the CD or the vinyl. Yeah, or
the actual stuff. So I think that in Japan, there are still okay. But, you know, we never know, because now the Spotify or Apple Music is so big, and people don't want to buy it unless they are a collector or they want to support.
Right.
That makes sense.
I use Apple Music, like I said earlier. I totally couldn't keep up with all the CDs.
Yeah, it's impossible. You need a lot of money.
Yeah, and for me, my taste and like stuff, like very rarely will I listen to a whole album. Like, I'll just listen to one or two songs from the album, then I'll jump to another record for another artist or blah, blah, blah. And so I would just have like a huge bag, you know, just like a huge book bag of CDs with me if I just wanted to listen to everything all the time. Yeah. Which maybe that's the way, who knows, you know.
Yeah.
Let's see. I'm going to go back to another question. Let's see, what do I have here? Have you ever been to any of the AVN Awards or no?
Which one? AUN?
Yeah.
No, I've never been to. I had a school.
Oh, no. Do you plan on going next year?
Hopefully, if it's happening.
Yeah, true. I think everything by next year should be fine, though.
I hope so. Like, I have... Like, I hope it's gonna... Like, everything is gonna calm down until... I know, by September. Oh, August.
That's what I'm thinking.
Because I have a ticket for Motley Crue reunion tour.
Oh, wow.
I got it. I got a $2,000 ticket. So.
Wow.
I actually don't want to miss that.
No, of course not. That's crazy. I actually just watched that documentary called The Dirt. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you like it?
It was actually surprising. It was... Okay, like it was surprisingly not bad.
Yeah. I'm usually not into like movies like that, but it was good.
It was actually good, and then I didn't know Machine Gun Kelly, but he was killing the Tommy Lee role.
Yeah, he absolutely crushed it.
Yeah, I mean, I was like, oh, this is actually not bad. I mean, it was a total surprising.
Yeah. What if have you been binge watching anything lately on like Netflix, you know, or whatever on the internet? Any weird shows?
No, I'm just rewatching Brooklyn Nine-Nine and Big Bang Theory.
Oh yeah. Did you ever watch any of that Tiger King nonsense?
I'm about to say that, but like every single American people are like, oh, this Tiger King meme, Tiger King whatsoever, Tiger King. Yeah, who killed who? That, like, wife killed somebody. Blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. And then I'm like, oh. Is that good? Like, I mean, I watched episode one, and then it wasn't really good. And then I was like, why people are watching this show? Did you watch
it? Yeah, I watched every episode, actually. You have to, Yeah, no, it's totally fine. You have to give it a few episodes. It's definitely really weird. Like, it takes a huge, huge plot twist that, you know, I wasn't really expecting.
So you gotta wait.
Yeah, I would say give it a watch. Maybe if you get bored, watch one more episode, and it may draw you in.
And did you like it?
I would say yeah.
Oh, okay.
just for this, the sake of, I mean, I kept watching it. I'm so picky with TV, you know? So if I found something that was interesting, I guess it was all right. The whole thing is, do you care if I spoil a little bit and I give you some of the plot?
I don't mind, really.
The whole thing is, so the everyone thinks that that lady killed her husband, because her husband just went missing, blah, 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 and they were trying to take down another big big cat, say, zoo that was like a rival, and the rival was talking about killing the lady and blah, 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 but that was all after. Anyways, this guy went missing, and she just described how to kill him and get away with the body, like, perfectly, and on the documentary, and blah, blah, blah. There's way more other stuff. You should just give it a watch, and then we'll talk about it.
Okay.
Let's see. So it is, it's Tuesday morning where you're at, correct? That's crazy. It's a nice Monday night here. It's like the end of the day for me. It's the beginning of the day for you.
Yeah, it's already like 10:30, so.
Do you have any big plans for a Tuesday?
I mean, streaming, as always. Nice.
Yeah, anybody that's watching, definitely go over and watch the stream after this.
Yeah, I'm not going to do anything, but like I'm just going to be there talking to people, doing games, and nothing interesting.
Yeah. Any other video games aside from the one that you mentioned that you're piquing interest in still?
I finished, I finished Resident Evil 5 and 6.
Yeah, I've actually never played any of those. I've heard that they're really good.
The Resident Evil series is, I think it's really good. Like, I haven't played 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 7. I played 7 a little bit, but yeah, if you like the co-op, like a co-op.
Yeah,
I mean, it's really, it was really fun. I was so bad at, I'm so bad at aiming, and then, I'm so bad at aiming, and then my friends needed to carry me a lot.
Yeah, I'm, I'm usually really bad at most video games. That's actually why I quit playing for so long. I would always have to just be kind of the weak link of the team, and everyone would kind of carry me. Except for, like, Super Smash Brothers. I'm really good at Super Smash Brothers.
Oh, you like Smash Bro?
Yeah, maybe I'm not really good. Do you play?
No. I tried. I tried on stream, and I liked it, but I just started another game because, like, I have so many requests, and they played try this one, try that one, and try this, try that, and then I got the VR headset, and then I got another game, and yeah, wow. So...
You get the whole virtual reality with it.
Yeah.
I've only done VR once, and it made me, like, really, really dizzy.
Motion sickness?
Yeah. It was, like, too intense. I don't know what was going on. And it was just Minecraft, too. It was something super simple. But yeah, I recently got a Switch, so I just started playing Super Smash again, because I had just been playing on tour with people that had a Switch, and so now I'm playing, so if you ever find yourself on that, we'll have to squad up on there, too. And
yeah, but I am so bad. I am playing the very easy mode right now.
Oh, okay, so. Yeah, maybe you'll have to train for a little while.
But if you want to do the Dead by Daylight, just let me know. I'm gonna be sitting here all day, so.
Totally. I'll probably download that actually after this.
Yes, you got it. Like, you have to try and tell me. Like, you have to give it a try, though. It's like a Tiger King. You have to do the Survivor like 3 or 4 times, and then you are getting like, oh, this is the shit.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, I should do that, because I've only been playing Warzone, and it's super fun, but it's just the same thing, you know?
Yeah. So it's a big, that. Big, it's a really a big, but it's really big on Twitch, though. You can probably, like, stream that.
Yeah. Surprisingly enough, I actually haven't streamed any video games yet. I've just been doing kind of like these formats far, which...
interview thing.
Yeah. I probably will start with the games, though, soon. This is only my fifth segment kind of thing, which thank you again for being on.
Thank you.
But yeah, I'll have to get on that, and we'll have to do that. I'm actually going to write that down, because if I don't do it right now, I'm going to forget about it.
Yeah, do it now.
Bart, you're my son.
Okay, it is now in my notes, and I'll never forget. let's see. We did wrestling favorites, least favorites. We did work favorite, least favorites. Here's a good one. What's one of your favorite metal bands that you've never seen live?
I've never seen live?
Yeah.
But this is...
I guess it doesn't even have to just be metal. It could just be, like, any band.
Oh, any band. But this is actually... one of my super favorite band I've never seen is Immortal. But...
Yeah.
Now, like, Abath is not there. So I'm like... Their new album was super good. So yeah. I want to see them, but without Abath, I'm not sure, but yeah, I want to give them a try. Like I want to check the Immortal if I can.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah. And then, Immortal, and then I've never seen, Van Halen.
That's a good one.
Yeah. Van Halen and, who else? I just forgot the name.
It's right there. It's right there. You got it. Yes.
I love scotch. I love scotch.
Billy Idol. Oh God.
There it is.
Yeah. Billy Idol.
Any others you could think of?
Yeah.
There's probably a lot.
Yes, yes, yes. Maybe like a Poison. I don't know.
Oh, yeah. A nice Rock of Love, Bret Michaels thing.
Yeah, and then Rat also.
What is one of your favorite festivals that you've been to? Have you been to many big ones? Yeah, I know you said you didn't go to any outside.
I've never been to like outside one, but like the festival called I forget the names super easily because it's in English. Beyond the Gates Festival. I went to the Beyond Gates Festival last year.
Where was that at?
No way. Belgium. Oh. Belgium. The Belgium is the place that church was burnt.
Okay.
By a bird.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then this festival was like the lineup, you can go crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite black metal drummer?
The black metal drummer. He's now not in the band anymore, but the Frederick with I don't know how to say his name properly, but Frederick he was the ex drummer of Martyr.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I got a painting of him right there. I don't think you can see it.
Oh, I can't see it because of the background.
Yeah. And he got a really nice, he is a really great artist. Yeah, Marduk always has six drummers. Yes, yes. And then I'm so sad that he is not in the band anymore.
Yeah, I haven't really followed them that much. How long has he been out of the band?
What?
How long have they had a different drummer? I haven't really been following that band.
Frederick, quit like last year. He was.
Oh, okay, so it's new.
He quit. Yeah, last year. Then now I think. Now the Mordek has a different drummer, and he was, I think. Oh, what band he was in? I don't remember, but the drummer is like playing for like Gorgoroth or something like that, I think.
Yeah, one of those extreme bands.
Yeah. I don't remember.
So, I'm going to pitch an idea to you, and this is something that's been in my head for a while, and I want to hear your opinion of it. Huh? I've had an idea of throwing a metal festival, but fusing it with like adult entertainment, to where there would be like dancers, like with poles on stages, you know, like a stage with poles, blah blah blah, like merch and everything too. Would you go to something like that? That's like a metal festival slash like adult festival, you know, where it's like, you know, stripper poles, dancers, people performing whatever you wanted, like no censorship.
Yeah, I mean, like if the lineup is good.
Like, yeah, totally. It would have to be like a big metal lineup, but then it would have to be like or like notable people in the industry as far as, you know, the porn side.
Yeah, I think I'm going to get jealous if I cannot get to perform or something, but
I will. So it sounds like we may have our first performer already confirmed then.
Yeah. Yay. Yeah, but like, I would love to, I think. It depends on the lineup.
Totally. I've always thought that it would just be such a cool fusion idea. Because I always like intertwining things that aren't really going to find themselves next to each other otherwise, so to say. For example, porn and a concert, you know? So I like the idea of fusing it all into one thing.
I mean, if you go to the Steve Panther concert, you can see boobs everywhere.
Well, yeah. Yeah. We're not all Steel Panther. I take it you've seen Steel Panther?
Yeah. They are my favorite. They are kind of like a joke band, but like their performance is like they're the true entertainers.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's so fun. Have you ever been to the concert?
Wait, what was it? You just cut up. What was it?
Have you ever seen their the show in the small venue or not? You don't have to be. Don't have to be small, but.
No.
Oh, it's so fun.
I've always wanted to see. I've seen online like videos and music videos.
It's so fun!
How was your Steel Panther show like? Tell us how your concert experience was.
Oh, I mean, like, I've been to like four times, or I've been to their concert like four or five times, and every time Asian Hooker is rolling or they're playing, they just pick me up on the stage and I just get naked. not completely naked, but like I just flash.
Yeah. I mean, boobs and Steel Panther go hand in hand, so.
Yeah, it's just so good. Like, I love the atmosphere. And then I love that it's allowed. Like,
girls
are, like, on the shoulder and showing the boobs to everyone. And,
It's so just good. Like a nice kind of, empowering, nice environment.
Yeah, it's like a big party.
Yeah. Let's see, that kind of brings me to another question that I kind of skipped over earlier. once you started doing like adult film and stuff, did you ever have a hard time telling your friends or family? Like, did they ever ask what you were doing and you had to kind of hide it?
My family doesn't know about it.
Really?
No. My friend, I don't care. I mean, like, if they want to ask. Like, I don't really have many friends, so that's super fine. Because, I mean, I don't have many friends, and then, like, yeah, I don't have to tell the people. But I don't know, so... but, like, I don't care if, like, anybody knows or my job or not. Like, it's my life, and they don't have any rights to talk about my life and stuff. So, it's not... Yeah, but my family doesn't know about it.
Right. Okay. Do you find that, like, even your friends that do know or anything, like, you're obviously very open with your work. Do you find that that's kind of liberating, or, like, kind of, like, you get a sense of pride, kind of, in your work?
Not really.
No?
I just wanted to be, like, I was a loser in high school and during high school. I was a total loser. I was a total nerd listening to, like, heavy metal every day. I was bringing, like, a magazine every day and lyric, like, notes. Like, notes and, like, how do you say, the insert.
Yeah,
I was bringing the insert every day, and I was, like, reading a lot of interviews, and I was, like, reading every single lyrics. I was remembering, and I was, like, translating, and I was a total loser. Like, I love that I did it, but, like, I didn't have any, like, many friends, or I didn't hang out with a lot of people. So I always wanted to be popular.
Oh, okay, I see.
I always wanted to be popular, and then I wanted to have people's attention, and now, in some way.
Well, I think you got it.
Not enough, but.
Not enough. I think, yeah. Well, let me ask. I noticed you're doing some tattoo removal as well. Did you just not like the tattoos? Is it just
my family didn't want to have any tattooed people in their family, so I was like,
Okay, so it's more of like a, shall I say, cultural kind of...
cultural reason.
Okay. Well, that's very nice of you and very, I guess, family-based to, you know, abide by things like that. Is that something you did while you were in the States or Europe, the tattoos? Or
Europe, yeah. I got some in Japan, but, like, I didn't really show them. And then they were like, what?
Yeah.
So.
Here you are. How many more sessions do you have until you think it's completely done?
I don't know. I like, this is, like, 7 times that it's still here. Yeah.
Interesting. I only have 3 myself, but I think they'll stay.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. Like, it's so painful.
Is it? What's worse? Is it worse getting it lasered off?
No, you cannot compare. The razor is the worst. You cannot compare, really.
Oh.
It's basically you're burning your skin. You're, like, it get burned, and then it fell off, and then you just repeat it.
Wow. Yeah, that's pretty metal.
Yeah. Yeah.
With the tattoo thing, do you mind, like, can I ask why? Is there, like, something, I guess, I know we said, like, cultural, but is there something bad that is tied along with tattoos?
Yeah, I think, like, I don't know, they think, like, it's a gang thing, or the bad people thing, or, like, a prisoner thing.
Yeah, so, like, they just kind of associate it with negativity.
Mm-hmm.
I could see that. I would say that there's definitely still a bit of that, even in the United States, with some of the older generations. And
yeah, that's a shame.
How long ago did you get yours, tattoos?
Huh?
How long did you have your tattoos?
I think it's like 3-4 years.
Okay, so you had them for a while.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Mm-hmm.
I recently, like 2 years ago, just got my first one, and I just have three now. Yeah, I got a buffalo on the back of my calf.
That's nice. 2 years ago.
Yeah, still new to the tattoo world.
Oh, you're still a baby. You just.
Yep, it's still a baby.
Yeah.
Boom, 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 boom. What are your thoughts of the current state of kind of just the world with COVID-19? Like, how early do you think we're gonna start going back to normal?
I don't know.
Yeah, like in an ideal world, like, is it getting any better in Japan? Like, what's it like over there right now? Yes.
It's so hard to tell it because I am streaming all day and then I don't watch TV and
right.
I don't go outside.
Yeah, okay, so you're not really keeping up with it.
Yeah, I actually don't know what's happening outside, but I think it's not as bad as America. Like, I think that, like, yesterday the total positive, like, the total positive were like 43 or something.
Right, which is really low.
Yeah, so I don't think Japan is not, and like, it's not gonna take time in Japan.
Yeah.
I was.
Yeah, where I'm at currently, in Georgia, the state that I'm in, we actually reopened last Friday, and like, everything is starting to open back up.
Nice.
But I think it's a little too soon because we still have a lot of cases, but that's not my decision.
Yeah, let's find out.
Yeah, I mean, there's only one way. We'll see if the next episode, you know, happens or not. Cool. Is there any topics you wanted to cover before we get towards the end? Is, you know, what's going on in your day-to-day life? Is there anything you wanted to mention? Or
not really. I mean, if you're watching my the stream, please just go follow my Instagram. And I have two Instagram accounts. One is for my main job, and one is for my vinyl collection and stuff. So if you are interested, like, I see that a lot of people, like, from the music industry is here, I'm guessing. So if you want to check out if I'm a poser or not, if I'm a poser or not, please go. Like, you don't have to follow, but you can see what I have and stuff.
I think you probably have more metal memorabilia than I do, and I've been touring exclusively with metal for the last 8 years, so I think you're no poser. I think you have me beat.
Yeah, who knows? You go and you find out.
Yeah, totally. Well, I just want to thank you again so much for having you on. We're nearing the end. Okay. I'm going to download that game.
Yes, please.
I will. Shoot me a message with your, you know, information, blah, 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 and I'll add you.
Okay. Yeah, please try, like, several times, like 3 or 5 or so, and then tell me the opinion.
I will. I will make sure to remember that. And, yeah, just message me your stuff and I'll add you. And, blah, blah, blah. But I guess that does it for today. I think we covered everything.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you so much for not judging me.
Oh, of course not. Thank you so much for coming on. And maybe we can do a part two post COVID-19 update afterwards.
Yeah, or we can do the Dead by Daylight streaming.
We can do that as well. Mm-hmm. I just have to get a partner first, then we can squat.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you so much for being here. To everyone watching at home, thank you for watching.
Thank you. I'm going to start streaming. So if you want to keep talking with me, please go to my page. And thank you so much. Peace out.
Awesome. Thank you, Rae. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.